What's up, guys? This is me, African Hair God. This is going to be a quick video on how I clean my hair tools, such as my combs, brushes, clips, whatever. I've gotten a lot of questions about how professionals clean their hair tools in the comment section. Over the past couple of years, and I kind of put it off, but I guess it is one of those things where it's not really discussed much on here. I guess it's one of those things that just kind of goes without saying. What I used to do in the past was use warm water and shampoo, let my tools soak in there, and then go in with like a brush and clean all the combs and brushes and things like that. It was very time consuming, and when you're in a salon and you're using multiple tools all the time and you have to reuse tools over and over and over again, you need something a lot more quicker, easier, effective to cleanse with, so that you can reuse those items as needed. So I'm here to talk about Ship Shape. Most of you probably have never heard of this before. I've never heard of this before until I started beauty school. That's when I was introduced to it. Ship Shape is a brush and comb cleaner. It's basically a powder that you mix with water to create a solution that will basically clean your combs and brushes. There are three levels of infection control procedures as mandated by the State Board of Cosmetology in the state of Georgia. First is sanitation, second is disinfection, and third is sterilization. I'm not going to talk too much about sterilization. That's something that's more in line with medical professionals. But Ship Shape would be a form of sanitation for your tools. Sanitation is nothing more than cleaning, which basically means you're just getting rid of any impurities or topical dirt, dust, product, things like that. It doesn't necessarily remove or destroy bacteria or prohibit its growth. Some cleaners do kind of reduce bacteria, but they're not strong enough to really effectively kill it. So I'll talk about disinfecting procedures in the salon after I talk about Ship Shape. So I got this Ship Shape at the beauty supply store. I paid about maybe $8 for this. It's probably like $7 or $8, and you get a good amount of this. The good thing is that you really don't need a lot of Ship Shape when you do use it. And the way to use it, what you're going to do is just take all of your tools, your combs, your brushes, whichever is dirty. You're going to lay them out. You want to remove all the hair that's in your combs or your brushes. You're then going to place your tools in either a sink or a plastic bin, and you're going to add some of the Ship Shape on top of your tools, and then add warm to hot water and allow your tools to soak in that solution. I leave my tools in for about 10 to 15 minutes. After you've added your water, you want to shake up your container a little bit to help break down the product and stuff that's on your combs and brushes. If it is safe for your hands, it's not any type of harsh chemicals that's going to, you know, cause any health hazards or anything like that. So that's a good thing. And after you've let them soak for about 10 to 15 minutes, you are then going to remove the solution, rinse your tools off very thoroughly, and then lay them out on a towel to air dry. And at that point, your tools should be clean. If they're not, then you would repeat the procedure, and then at that point, it should definitely be clean. Ship Shape, even though it is a really good cleanser for professionals like myself, if you are just someone at home that doesn't really use a lot of tools or anything like that, you probably don't need to go out and get Ship Shape. You could probably get away with just using Dawn or using, you know, a shampoo that you don't really care for or something like that. But if you're someone who is, say, a stylist, you do hair on the side, you have a lot of hair tools, you're doing your kids' hair a lot, it's definitely something that is nice to have around the house. Only thing I would say with Ship Shape is you don't want to leave certain tools in there for too long. I remember I used to leave my Dimon brush in for a very long period of time, and the rubber started to, it didn't disintegrate or anything, but it just became really discolored. So if that's something you're concerned about, just make sure you stick to 10 to 15 minutes and then remove your tools out of the solution. So that's basically how professionals, licensed cosmetologists, how I clean my hair tools. Next, I'll talk a little bit about disinfection. For those of you that don't know, a disinfectant is anything that is designed to destroy or inhibit the growth of microorganisms that cause diseases. What stylists and barbers use is a liquid known as barbicide. You can find this at hospitals too because, well, all of our professions are actually related. People don't hold cosmetologists to the same degree as they do medical professionals, but you'd be surprised that we deal with a lot of the same stuff that medical professionals deal with. But anyways, us stylists, we use barbicide. Barbicide is a liquid solution that is barbicidal, virucidal, fungicidal, and pseudomonicidal. So it's basically designed to, it doesn't clean anything, but what it does do is disinfect and kill all those microorganisms and bacteria, viruses, and it's even designed to kill the HIV virus if your tools come in contact with that. So that's something very important, especially when you're dealing with multiple people who have different stuff going on with their scalp and their hair. You don't want to use a tool on one person and then clean it and think you're doing something good, and then you go on and to the next person and you done gave the next person ringworm. That's horrible. So that's why the State Board of Cosmetology mandates that we not only sanitize, but we disinfect our tools as well. Sanitation is very, very important, especially in a professional salon environment, whether it's a nail salon, a barbershop, or a hair salon. You have to keep a mind out when you are at these establishments. If you see someone drop a comb and they pick it back up and don't do nothing with it, or they pick it back up and put it back in your hair, you need to stop that service and leave, because that is definitely out of State Board compliance and they are putting your hair and your health at risk, and that is nasty. I will also go on to say, for those of you that have children, that have sons that go to the barbershop, get their little hair shaped up and have the barber use a little sponge to give them the little BB naps, as I call them, I would recommend that you not allow the barber to use their sponge, but you would actually bring your own personal sponge for your child to use, because you cannot properly sanitize and disinfect porous materials. Think about it. You wouldn't use a sponge that you clean the toilet with to wash your dishes with. That'd be nasty because it's porous and it's going to hold all that bacteria and everything. It's going to just continue to grow and reproduce, and that's nasty. So you shouldn't expect barbers to be able to disinfect their hair sponges. And you also have to keep in mind, most barbers don't shampoo their clients before styling their hair. So they're just taking a sponge, rubbing dirty hair with it, and then your child is sitting in the chair and they're getting their hair rubbed with a dirty sponge as well. That's just an opportunity for bacteria and fungus and all different types of infections to occur. So just got me choking up. Just a FYI for those of you, look out for those barbers and those sponges. Just take your own and you'll be fine. But for you at home, I wouldn't say it's necessary for you to go and get barbicide and disinfect your tools. If you're just using your tools for yourself, then I would say that you would only need to sanitize your tools properly to create, to just discourage any type of bad situations for your hair and your scalp. But for us in a professional environment where we're working with all different types of people all the time, back to back to back to back, it's very, very important that we not only sanitize but disinfect as well. So I hope you took a lot from this video. That's all I have for you guys. Thank you so much for watching. And until the next video, be blessed. Bye. Perfect.